evening, folks, and thanks very much, Cullen. Now, we've got a very short time, so I'm going to invite my colleagues, Mick Buckley and Helen O'Donovan, on stage. We normally open the Singers Club with a song. I usually sing the first song, but I'm not going to sing the first song tonight. I'm going to leave that to Helen. But I just want to explain that the Singers Club grew out of the Cork Folk Festival. In the Cork Folk Festival, which we started back in 1979, we always had an emphasis on songs, always song sessions. And right from the beginning, we had a little song competition. The current Cork Folk Festival still has song competitions, both in the traditional idiom and in the contemporary song idiom. And for example, over the years, people like Noel Brazil, Confado Driscoll, and even Don for Chickens, the great Mick Lynch, had a song in and won. And some of you know that song. They're not from Cork. We're Norries, we're Sorries, we're Martians. We come from the banks of the Lee. And it goes on, and it's a great contemporary song made by a man who spent a lot of his life in the punk rock business. Some of you will know that Mick was with Stump in the old days. So the Singers Club emerged out of the Cork Folk Festival. What we try to do is we try to keep songs alive. They don't survive unless they're sung. And the songs that we sing, there's no limit. So songs in Irish, Shannos, songs in the English tradition, like the child ballads, and even some of the contemporary songs written by all sorts of people, they all get an airing at the Cork Singers Club, which is going for 23 years. So I'm watching the time, and I hope Colin will keep me in order. And I'm going to sing a song myself at the end, if there's time. But one of the singers, who has a great collection of songs, some of them in the English idiom, is my colleague here, Helen O'Donovan. So, warm welcome for Helen.
Explain a little bit about this song. It's called The Unfortunate Lass. I got it from Joe Power, who runs a singing session as well down in Dungarvan and Waterford. A lovely singing session down there. And he gave it to me quite a few years ago. But it has two or three different titles, I'd write down the back. It's called The Unfortunate Lass, which I sing it under. It also has Young Girl Cut Down Her Prime, and there are different versions, and it's also called The Bad Girl. Shirley Collins, Norman Watson, Elsa Carty, but sang it as well. So this is my version. As I went to walking one fine summer's morning, as I went walking one midsummer's day, I spied a young woman all dressed in white linen, all dressed in white linen and cold as the clay. When I was on horseback, wasn't I pretty? When I was on horseback, wasn't I grand? Oh, wasn't I pretty when I entered Cork City? And I met with my downfall on the 18th of May. Mother, dear mother, come sit down beside me. Come sit down beside me and hear my sad case. For I loved a soldier who's lately deserted. He's gone and he's left me in shame and disgrace. Daughter, dear daughter, why did you not tell me? Why did you not tell me of this in good time? For I'd brought salts and the pills of white myrrh.
mercury. You're a true-hearted maiden cut down in your prime. Ah, doctor, dear doctor, come fill up your bottles. Ah, fill up your bottles and keep them quite dry. For me bones, they are aching, me heart, it is breaking. I'm in so much disgrace, I know I will die. Get 6 jolly soldiers to carry my coffin. Find 6 jolly sailors who'll sing up a song. And 6 comely maidens to carry white roses. Oh, so you can smell them as we go along. And beat the drum slowly and play the fifes lowly. Sound out the dead march now as we go along. Take me to Tipperary and lay me down easy. I'm a true-hearted maiden who never done wrong. Thank you.
There, part of Helen singing, you were all listening. And one of the things about the Singers Club, there's as much importance in listening to the songs as in singing them. And sometimes people from abroad wonder why we've got such a strong emphasis on singer-songwriters in this country, and why singer-songwriters have made it in Ireland before they've made it in the UK or in the United States. And one of the reasons is Irish audiences listen. So that's just something to bear in mind. As I said, there's a whole range of songs in the Singers Club, and in the tradition, there's urban and rural, and some of you will know Jimmy Crowley and what he's done for the singing, and there's a particular song which a lot of people in the city here know as the Groves of Blackpool, and they think it's kind of the local anthem for Blackpool, but I'm going to get my colleague there, Mick Buckley, to sing it in a moment, but it's actually an Ireland song, an old loyalist song, sung a long time ago, back in the 18th century, so would you please welcome Mick Buckley.
Nancy is over, and peace has come over from France, and our gallant Cork City militia once more to headquarters advance. No longer a beating those rebels, we'll now be a beating the bull, and all other genteel recreations that's found near the groves of Blackpool. Out came our loving relations to see were we living or no. Likewise our jolly old neighbours who all around the stiff locked in a row. The nagging of sweet Tommy Walker we lifted according to rule, and we wetted our necks with the natives that's brewed near the groves of Blackpool. When our regiment entered the commons, it would do your heart good for to see. You'd swear not a man or a woman was left in Cork's famous city. The young lads, they all flocked around us, no hat or wig stuck to his skull, celebrating those brave Irish heroes that sprang from the groves of Blackpool. When our regiment entered the commons, it would do your heart good for to see. You'd swear not a man or a woman was left in Cork's famous city. The young lads, oh, we sang that one ago. The young lads, they all flocked around us, no hat or weak stuck to his skull, celebrating those brave Irish heroes that sprang from the groves of Blackpool. And sure, there's not a nation in Munster where the groves of Blackpool could compare, where our heroes were all educated and the nymphs are so comely and fair. The gardens around entertaining with sweet pretty posies so full, that are worn by those comely young creatures that walks in the groves of Blackpool. Short as many's a time late and early, I wish I was landed again to see the sweet water course flowing where the tanners their glory maintain, and beside that divine habitation where the babbies were all sent to school, who never had father or mother but were found near the groves of Blackpool. Come, come all you young lads of this nation, come fill up a bumper all round, drink success to Blackpool navigation, and may she with plenty be crowned. Success to the jolly hoop coilers, likewise to the shuttle and spool, to the skinners and worthy glue boilers that lives in the groves of Blackpool. The groves of Blackpool. Thank you.
I know we're under severe time pressure, but that gives you some kind of flavour what we do in the Singers Club. And I've just spoken to Colin. I'm just going to sing a short song as well, just to give you an idea how. Here's a song which sounds like an old song. It's actually relatively recently written, and some of you will have heard a little aspect of this. A long time ago in the county Mayo, this story it first began. Before immigration was finally cured by the first economical plan, a brave young boy had to leave his home and to travel across the sea. But he got well paid in the building trade on the shores of America. He got on very well, but he sent nothing home, and his mommy began to think that he'd run away with a blonde, or that he was spending his money on drink. He wrote him a letter, she folded it up, and she sent it on its way. And on the cover she clearly wrote, "To my son in America." Well, the postman collected the letter she wrote, and he drove in his van to Cork. He placed it in a liner at Cove, which landed it up in New York. And there on the quay, all the mailbags they lay, and a whiskey alongside also. And among the rest was one letter addressed to my son in America. Well, American postmen I need not relate, but they're rather like me and you. And when they came to this letter at last, sure they didn't know what to do. They looked up all the official lists, but these they had nothing to say. There was no directory to help them to find a son in America. Well, it lay around the office for years, and it gave all the lads a laugh. Until in the end, it found a use in the training of the staff. To every young postman that came on the job, it was shown up as Exhibit A, being unofficially addressed to my son in America. Well, the son, he grew older and wiser too, and at last to himself he said, "Or how is it with me mommy at home now, or is she alive or dead?" He walked round the block to the GPO, where he stood with his cap in his hand, be any chance, would there be a letter for me from me mother in Ireland? Well, indeed, kind sir, no, and here it is, we've been waiting for you for years. We knew that someday someone would come out of Cork or from old Donegal. With 200 million that's living now in the whole of the USA. For a mother in Ireland, at last we have found her son in America.